Hello everyone, I'm Darshan Joshi. I joined ENTS program in fall 2016 and I did my internship at Comsco as a wireless software developer. And before coming to ENTS program, I had 2 years of experience at identity technology services, which was basically into LTE protocol stack development. And I would say that that was a very fundamental project that helped me, you know, getting internship. Before I go into, you know, how I got internship and all, first thing that you need to, you know, make sure even before applying for internship is to find out whether you want to do internship or you want to do some independent project, because that is also not something that you should, you know, rule out. Because when you are doing your master's course, you are getting a lot of technical skills, and if you are, you know, confident that you can apply your own skills and do your own project, then that is also something that you should not rule out. And if you, let's say, you plan to do internship, I guess most of you would want to go for internship, then I will tell that in my case, I got a reference from my previous company. So the manager for whom I used to work, I contacted him, and something that I was really sure about that where actually I wanted to work into. So I knew that what is LTE protocol stack is. I knew there are, as Swaran mentioned, there are operation side of RF engineering, and there are software development side, and there is ongoing research. So I knew that I wanted to work into physical layer and MAC layer. So the person whom I approached, I mentioned him clearly that, see, I'm looking for some opportunity where I can use my skill into physical or MAC layer. And certainly that helped me, because he realized that I'm not just asking for favor, but he knew that I want to use my skills into particular domain, not just getting an internship. And when he went through my mail, he actually found out companies who are working into similar kind of technologies, or who has certain products already out in the market. So there is this company called Arwana, which had an award-winning small cell product out there in the market. And Comscope had acquired that company in 2015. And the manager under whom I worked had some contacts in that company. So he forwarded my resume there. But the funny thing is that he put Qualcomm instead of Comscope. So when he changed the resume and the cover letter, instead of putting Comscope, he put Qualcomm. But the fact that in my cover letter I had explained extensively what technology I want to work into, and I had previously worked into OFDM project. There's one really interesting course in ENTS program, OFDM. If you are really interested into, you know, physical layer and MAC layer, I would really suggest you to go for that course. And my 2B manager, he actually set up an interview in December itself. So that was well before, I guess, anyone in the ENTS program who had actually got an internship call. And I was not really prepared to, you know, give an interview, because it was something overwhelming, because I thought that during the winter I'll prepare for, you know, interviews, and then I'll start apply for that. So so I went through the interview process. There were 2 to 3 rounds of interviews. And that was the only company that I got a call from, and that was the only company that I went for. Now going into the internship role, I'll just give you the brief idea what I worked on to. So there is something called automatic gain control. So before I go into that, the funny thing is my role was as a software developer, but mostly work that I did was into hardware engineering. Because the company dynamic is as such that they wanted a person to get, because I was a part of software team, and most of the senior members into software team didn't know how to, I mean, they knew how to use, but they wanted someone to get expertise into the hardware department. So my company was basically divided into software, hardware, and system engineering. System engineering come up with all the algorithms. They decide the primary documentation that you need for a product. Then hardware team goes and make a layout of how the future product would look like. And software team start developing on the software side of it. And there is a competition. Even if you are a part of such a big company, there's a competition between software, hardware, and system engineering. because system engineering would say that, okay, we came up with such algorithm, but software team has not done their work. So they wanted me to go into hardware and learn how hardware team basically come up with their, you know, their ideas. So I worked on lot of spectrum analyzers, and they gave me actual next generation board and asked me to do a lot of work on that. So the first task that I was given, so I was given basically three projects. First was into protocol, PTP protocol. That is a synchronization protocol. I don't know whether you have heard about it or not. So they wanted me to check whether we can implement that new protocol in the next generation product or not. So as Swanand also mentioned, first few weeks are all about getting to know the product, and because it's a work of, you know, 10 years of development, research and development, because that's the extensive part of very successful product. So I went through a lot of documents. I understood basically what makes the product such an outstanding product. So I first few weeks I learned the product, then I did the task that I was supposed to do. The second project that I was given was to make a framework, testing framework in MATLAB to integrate your DSP and FPGA. So a lot of algorithms that they have works on DSP, but they were moving from DSP to FPGA, and they wanted to do the testing on MATLAB even before going into actual, you know, implementation. So that was the second task, and my third task was basically working on AGC. Now AGC is I don't know whether you have heard about it or not. The software defined radio. So a lot of hardware also now runs based on the software that you have, and they have certain configuration that is required to make your receiver and transmitter work properly. And one of the experienced guy over there, he had done one configuration, and he wanted me to actually implement out on the hardware and see whether things work properly or not. So this was the task that I was given was really interesting. I don't know whether I did work as per their expectation or not, but there was a lot of support from the team over there. So it definitely, even though I came with 2 years of experience, this was something totally different. I worked in a service-based company, and my work was into product-based company, so that really helped me. This was all about my internship, and I'll answer if you have any questions.